patrol plane. Routine patrol. Only behind every cloud may be an enemy. Midway Island. Not much land, right enough. But it's our outpost. Your front yard. Natives of Midway. Tojo has sworn to liberate them. The birds seem nervous. There's something in the air. Something behind that sunset. Excitement this morning. The Dawn Patrol has sighted an enemy fleet. During the night, flying fortresses had landed at Midway.
A historic council of war is held.
That fella's walk looks familiar. My neighbor's boy used to amble along just like that. Say, is that one of them flying fortresses?
Yes, ma'am, it is.
Why, that's young Will Timmy. He's from my hometown, Springfield, Ohio. He's not going to fly that great big bomber.
Yes, ma'am, that's his job. He's a skipper.
Will's dad is an engineer. 38 years on the old Ironton Railroad. And his mother, huh? Well, she's just like the rest of us mothers in Springfield or any other American town. And his sister, Patricia, she's about as pretty as they come.
I'll say so.
Will Junior Kinney.
Suddenly, from behind the clouds, The Japs attack! The Jap fleet. Navy planes roared from the decks of our carriers, army bombers, marines, thundered destruction over a 300-mile battle area.
Thank you.
enemies were hit and hit and hit again.
Men and women of America, here come your neighbor's sons, home from the day's work. You want to meet them. There's Jimmy Thatch, 7 meatballs on his plane.
How many more today, Skipper?
At Midway, Tojo swore he'd liberate the natives.
They seem just as free as they ever were.
Battle of Midway is over. Our front yard is safe. But a big job is still to be done. Day after day, our patrol planes search for survivors. Every tiny coral reef, every distant mile of sea. Search for men who fought to the last round of ammunition and flew to the last drop of gas and then crashed into the sea. 8 days, 9 days, 10 days without food or water.
His first cigarette.
Boy, that first drag sure tastes good.
Eleven days. Well done, Matthew Hughes. Logan Ramsey. Frank Fessler?
That's 13 for Frank.
And cool sheets. Get them doctors and medicine, the nurses' soft hands. Get them to the hospital. Hurry, please.
There was a hospital, clean, orderly, 100 beds, and on its roof the Red Cross plainly marked. The symbol of mercy the enemy was bound to respect.
Next morning, divine services were held beside a bomb crater that had once been a chapel. At eventide, we buried our heroic dead, the last salute from their comrades and their officers.
Out of the Navy. Colonel Shannon.
Major Roosevelt.